Good morning, students. Today we are continuing this chapter, sexual reproduction in flowering plants. In that chapter, last class we discussing the different types of pollinating agents. Today we are discussing another bit, that is outbreeding devices used by the plants to prevent self-pollination or autogamy and encouraging the cross-pollination or autogamy. So here, why they are needed this one? So before that, we are discussing what is used by self-pollination and what is used by cross-pollination. So self-pollination is a pollination of, the pollination takes place in the same flower. It's called as the self-pollination or autogamy. The pollination takes place in different flowers, either in the same plant or different plant. It is called as the cross-pollination or allogamy. So, why they are using this outbreeding devices to prevent self-pollination? Why they needed the self-pollination to prevent? That we will discuss here. So, that is outbreeding devices. Hermaphrodite flowers can undergo continuous self-pollination. So, hermaphrodite flowers means the bisexual flowers, can undergo continuous self-pollination which cause the inbreeding depression in them. So, what is known by inbreeding depression? Inbreeding depression refers to decrease or loss of strength of a plant. The growth, the fitness of the plant will decreases. So that loss of or the decrease of strength or the fitness of the plant is called as the, is caused due to the self-pollination or inbreeding. So that is called as the inbreeding depression. Remember that inbreeding depression. What does this mean? It refers to decrease or loss of fitness or strength of plant. Which is caused due to continuous inbreeding or self-pollination. So to avoid this, to avoiding the inbreeding depression, the plants will adapt some outbreeding devices and encouraging the cross-pollination. To avoiding the inbreeding depression, plants will prevents the self-pollination and encouraging the cross-pollination. So that they required some of the outbreeding devices which are as follows. We will discuss that one. First one is the avoiding synchronization, or it is also called as decogamy. First one, outputting devices, that is avoiding synchronization. What is synchronization? You will discuss here. Or it is also called as decogamming. Okay, so what is avoiding, why they are avoiding the synchronization? So here the developing of or maturation of the endosium or pollen release from the endosium or from the anther before they are the stigma will get the receptivity. So here the pollen is released before the stigma get receptivity or before stigma will becomes receptive. So here first one is the avoiding synchronization, in that pollen releases from the anther before stigma get receptive. Receptive means the term where the stigma will are able to catch the pollen. So the a phenomena at that time the stigma get there, the catching the pollen grains, that is called as the receptive. So here the pollen is releases from the anther before stigma get receptive, or in other vice versa, that is stigma get or sorry lose the receptive or receptivity before pollen is released. So to avoiding the synchronization is simultaneously they are carried out these processes, but here they are avoiding that one. Pollen releases from anther, as soon as they are releasing the stigma get the receptivity, but here it is different. Pollen is releases from anther before stigma get receptive, or stigma lose the receptivity before the pollen is released. So this is the first the outputting devices which are get by the plants to avoid the self-pollination and encouraging the cross-pollination. Here it prevents, what it prevents? Autogamy. It prevents autogamy. So here the two terms will comes. One is the protoendry, another term is the protogamy. Protogamy. So what is in the protoendry and protogamy? So protoendry, where the endosium develops or matures earlier than the gynosium. So endosium matures earlier than gynosium. In protoendry, gynosium matures earlier than androgen. So these two terms will come. So here, avoiding the synchronization, they are the developing of the androecium in different times. So androecium matures earlier than gynoecium, so that they cannot meet each other. Gynoecium, gonoglans and the stigma cannot meet each other when the androecium matures before the gynoecium, or the gynoecium matures earlier than the androecium. So to avoid the self-pollination, these type of the outbreeding device, they are adapted. So this is the first one. Second, the arrangement of anther and stigma at different position. Second thing is the arrangement of anther and stigma or the pistil at different position. So from that, what happens to the self-pollination? So second device, the arrangement of the anther and stigma at a different position. So the arrangement of anther and stigma at different position, from this what happens? It also prevents autogamy or self-pollination. How means? If they are positioned in different position, if the stigma is a higher, superior ovary, that is the higher position the stigma is present and anther present at the lowest positions, so they cannot meet to each other. There is the pollen grains cannot meet to the stigma and there is no pollination takes place. So that type of the pollination, to avoid the self-pollination, to prevent the self-pollination or autogamy, they carried out this type of the device, that is arrangement of anther and stigma at different position. So it also prevents the self-pollination or autogamy. Third device is the self-incompatibility. Self-incompatibility, or it is also called as self-sterility. It is also called as self-sterility. So what is self-incompatibility? It is a genetic mechanism for preventing pollen growth on stigma. So it is a genetic mechanism how by preventing the pollen growth on stigma. So how they are preventing that one? With the help of the self-sterile gene. The pollen is not growing onto the same flower stigma. So it is a genetic mechanism where by preventing pollen growth on stigma of a same flower. Means same flower stigma will not be growing. On the same flower stigma, pollen are not growing. So they can grow other flowers, they can grow to other flowers or to other plants flowers, other species flowers, but they cannot grow onto the stigma of a same flower. So here the cell pollination is prevented, but that not the cross pollination. So due to that, the presence of the steroid, which occurs due to the self sterile gene. So here it is a genetic mechanism by preventing pollen growth on stigma of a same flower, it caused due to the presence of self sterile gene. Examples, you can take the potato or tobacco. In that plants, the self incompatibility, compatibility means right type of pollens, incompatibility means wrong type pollen grains. So here the self incompatibility means same flowers pollens is not compatible to that stigma. That is due to the presence of the self sterile gene. This is the main thing. So self sterile gene is present in them. They avoid the pollen growth on stigma. By preventing the pollen growth on stigma of a same flower, there is the cross pollination will get out. There is the avoiding the cell pollination. That's why it is called as the self incompatibility or self sterility. Self sterility. So next, another type of the altering devices we will discuss here. Next device is the production of unisexual flowers. Production of unisexual flowers. So production of unisexual flowers, it is also called as declining. It is also called as declining. In this condition, where the plants producing the unisexual flowers, plant producing the unisexual flowers, that is either staminate flower that is male flower or pistillate flowers. Or female. Okay, so here in these conditions, the plants producing the either staminate flowers or pistillate flowers. So staminate flowers means it is a only male flower. There is no the female reproductive structure in that. That is the gynoecium is absent. Whereas pistillate flower, where the it is a female flower, where the male gamete reproductive structure is absent. That is androecium is absent, where only the gynoecium is present. So from this there is a preventing the cell pollination or autogamy, but not the cross pollination. It promoting, it encouraging the cross pollination. So some examples you can take, that is the monoecious. Monoecious, the bisexual flower, bisexual plant. Here the monoecious plant is there, monoecious plant, but not the bisexual flower. Okay. Here examples about the castor and mace. This will examples we can take earlier also. So monoecious plant, the castor and mace, where the they are producing the two types of flowers. One is the staminate flower and another is the pistillate flowers in different positions, where they require the biotic pollinating agents, that is insects are required. So monoecious plants, castor and mace, where the prevention of autogamy, prevention of autogamy, but not the gametogamy. Gametogamy takes place, but not the autogamy. So here the producing the unisexual flowers, but not the unisexual plants. Plants are monoecious, but the flowers are unisexuals, which are produced in different positions. So where they require the biotic pollinating agents, where they are preventing the autogamy, but not the gametogamy. Another example we can take, that is the dioecious plant. Example is papaya, where the different plants are produced. That is unisexual plants are produced, dioecious plants are produced, so that they are not easily can done the self pollination. There is no pollination, self pollination. There is only the cross pollination takes place, because the plants are different. Thus, the staminate plants is different and the pistillate plant is different. So here the unisexual plants are produced where the autogamy is prevented and gametogamy is also prevented. So both are prevented, but not the gametogamy. As you know that gametogamy is a cross pollination. So in the dioecious plant or the unisexual plant, where the autogamy and the gametogamy is prevented, but not the gametogamy, it will be promoting the cross pollination. Whereas the monoecious plant, such as castor and mace, where the autogamy is prevented, but not the gametogamy. Gametogamy is the type of pollination where the pollination takes place in the different flower of the same plant. So that is called as the gametogamy. So these are the fourth outbreeding device which are used by the plants to prevent self pollination and encouraging cross pollination. Next device we will explain that is natural physical barriers natural physical barriers natural physical barriers that prevents to meet off or to growth of pollen onto the stigma or the growth of pollen tube into the style. That is called as the hypogamy. So natural physical barriers prevent growth of pollen onto the stigma and pollen tube growth, into the style. This is called as hypogamy. Hypogamy means the natural physical barriers which prevents the growth of pollen onto the stigma, or it is also prevents the pollen tube formation or pollen tube growth in this style also. That is called as the hypogamy. So these are the five outbreeding devices which are utilized by the plants to prevent self-pollination and encouraging the cross-pollination. Okay, next we are discussing the another bit or another topic, that is the pollen stick interactions. Pollen pistil interactions. Why this pollen and pistils are interacting? They carried out the pollination when they are interacting to each other. So interactions, how it is done? So how they are carried out these interactions into the flower, that is either into the bisexual flower or the unisexual flowers. That is pollen pistil interaction. Pollen pistil interaction. It is a process in which pistil recognizes the compatible, that is the right type, or incompatible, that is the wrong type of pollen to carry out the pollination with the help of producing the chemical substances from that. So it is a process It is a process where pistil will recognizes the pollen whether it is compatible right type or incompatible or wrong type pollen to carry out the pollination by the help of chemical secreted or produced by them. So this is about the pollen pistil interaction. It is a process in which pistil recognizes pollen either compatible, that is right type, or incompatible that is wrong type through the chemical produced by them. So pollen pistil interactions, it is a process in which pistil will recognizes pollen whether it is the compatible or right type or the incompatible wrong type. How it is recognizes? With the help of the chemical which is produced by them, which is produced by pistil only, that chemical will recognizes the whether it is pollen is compatible, right type is there, or the it is wrong type is there. So if the pollen is compatible, what happens? If the pollen is compatible, that is right type of the pollen is present, that will be catched by the pistil, or pistil will accept that and they are carried out the post pollination events. So post pollination events means what? The fertilization as well as the post fertilization events. So here the whether it is compatible, if the pollen is compatible right type, at that time the pistil will accept them and carried out the promoting the post pollination events. If pollen grains will catch by pistil or will accept by pistil, what happens? Pollen will germinate onto the stigma. Pollen will germinate onto the stigma. With the help of stigma and tissue of style, they are growing into the style by the pollen tube of the one germ pores. So, if the pollen is accepted by pistil, onto the stigma, after the germination onto the stigma, to produce a pollen tube, they can produce the pollen tube. We can produce the pollen tube. After the pollen tube formation, they are growing inside the through the tissue of the stigma as well as through the tissue of the style. They are growing and reaches to the ovary, which is through the is one germ pore of the pollen. So if a pollen is compatible, it germinates onto the stigma, which is producing the pollen tube through the style, through the stigma tissues. They are growing continuously through this one of the germ pores of pollen and reaches to the ovary of the ovule. So this is about the when the pollen is compatible. So we can discuss this with the help of a diagram. Like this. So you can observe here the ovule is present. Okay, this is the ovule and here the pollens are present. These are the pollens which are accepted by stigma. One of them will reaches to the ovule. Where within the ovule, you know that there is a structure is present that is called the female gametophyte or ovule. These are the structures. Different types of cells are present, you know that. So here it is reaches to the this embryo sac. Different types of pollens are growing, but one of them it is only growing continuously and reaches to the ovary. So this is the pollen grains. This is pollen tube. This is style and this is antipodal cells. This is polar nuclei. Synergies. This is egg cell. So here you can observe that one of the pollen grain will growing the pollen tube through these style tissues. From the one of the germ pore, there is a pollen tube formation which takes place and which reach to the ovule within the ovary. So where we observe the different types of cells in the embryo sac, that is antipodal cells, the synergid cells and the egg cells which are present, and centrally located polar nuclei are also present. So where the post-pollination events is takes place. If the pollen is compatible at that times, pistil will accept them and the germinating of that pollen onto the stigma, and they form the, they producing the pollen tube through the stigma tissue as well as style tissue, and from the one of the germ pores of them, and they reaches to the ovary. So this is about the when the it is compatible type of the, or the right type of the pollen. If when the pollen is incompatible or the wrong type, the pistil will rejects them. The pistil will rejects that pollens by preventing pollen germination onto the stigma or through the style. So when the pollen is incompatible or the wrong type, at that time what they are do, when the incompatible pollen is present or the wrong type pollen is present, it rejects by the pistil, it rejects by the pistil by preventing pollen germination, by preventing the pollen germination onto the stigma, onto the stigma and onto the into the style also. So here you can observe that. So this is the one of the pollen grain which is not growing onto the stigma, means it is a rejected or incompatible pollen. So wrong type pollen. So wrong type pollens will be rejected by the pistil by preventing to grow onto the stigma or into the style. So that is the one thing when the pollen is incompatible. When it is compatible, it germinates, it accepts by the pistil and germinates onto the stigma and producing the pollen tube through the one of the germ pore from the style and as well as the stigma tissue and reaches to the ovary. So where they are carried out the post-pollination events. So what type of the post-pollination events is takes place, how the pollen tube content will be released into the ovary or into the ovule, so that we will discuss in next class. Thank you.